Okay, good morning, USA. Thanks for attending this webinar based on the plant material breeding program in France. I am Laurent Deguin. I've been working for the French Vine and Wine Institute for 27 years now. And I would like to thank the steering committee, EnoForum, for inviting me, for giving me the possibility to present what has been done in France and what are the next new challenges for the wine industry. A brief comment about IFV. IFV stands for French Vine and Wine Institute. We are a technical institution in charge of the research and development for the whole wine industry and the nursery industry, starting from the plant breeding, from the clonal selection to the wine's quality. We are about 160 people. The budget of IFV is about 15 million euro. That could be 18 US dollars. And we have several locations based in the French vineyard, as you can see on the map. And the head office is based, as you can see in the red circle, in Le Gros du Roi, where is located the French selection center. There are two subsidiaries for the French Vine and Wine Institute, IFV Service and Antam International, in charge of the development of the selection in France, in Europe, and in the wine countries like the USA. And I'm personally in charge of the plant breeding program, the coordination at the national scale for clonal selection and breeding. And I am also in charge of the development of the trademark. The reason why I know quite well your country, mainly the west side, the west coast, the California. The first time I visited the California was 30 years ago now. Anyway, so few key dates and major events since the middle of the 19th century in France. On the right side, some disease and some improvement in the knowledge about virus and selection. As you know, everybody knows, most of the fungal disease come from the North America, like powdery mildew, downy mildew, and black rot. A special event starting in the 1860 was the arrival of the phylloxera that destroyed the French vineyard. Then at the beginning of the 20th century, the knowledge about virus disease and its and their transmission has been developed. We knew since that date more about fan leaf, about the nematodes that transmit grapevine fan leaf virus and Arabis mosaic virus. And on the left, some events about the collection of plant material, about the development of an organization for the plant and cutting control and supply, and INRA started in 1946, ANTAV in 62. The first registered clones started in 71. Trademark ANTAV INRA established 26 years ago. And a big event for us in Le Gros du Roi in Espiguet was when we started hybridization 8 years ago. So our location is near the Mediterranean Ocean, where we are only on sandy soil without any risk of, without any nematodes, without any underground phylloxera, and the location is quite well isolated to commercial vineyards. Few words about what do we understand by clonal selection. Clonal selection is a selection of a single vine, and everything starts in an old vineyard or in repositories. We introduce the cuttings in Espiguet in our facility during the winter season, obviously, and then we have a clone head. We keep it in pot, and we do on the left side of the slide, we do in IFV, in Espiguet, the sanitary selection based on some virus disease and based on some methods like ELISA, PCR, and indexing. So we do nothing really special. We do the same they've been doing at the FPS UC Davis in California. Meantime, we start with our local partners, genetic or agronomic selection. That means getting information of the technologic profile of the clones. At the end of the process, when we do have the final results for the clonal selection, for the sanitary selection and the genetic selection, we can submit, we can apply for the registration of a clone. And there is a committee, CTPS, that which stands for the Permanent Selection Technical Committee, a vine section, that decides if we can have a new official clone being registered. So what did we obtain after 60 years of clonal selection? More or less 1,300 official clones. I like to present and to explain we had three generations of clones. The first one, the first have been, as I said, registered in 71. And during the first 20 years, we had the first generation. The first generation of virus-free clone and high-yielding clones. I put on the slide some example. Then the focus was more on qualitative clones. That meant clones with low yielding clones, clones with a high potential of accumulation of sugar, and for the red wines, for the red clones, for the red cultivars, a big potential in terms of polyphenol. We are working now on the third generation, which means diversity and getting special characteristics. And for some key varieties, I put on the slide some number of clones that have particular characteristics. So we are still working on the clonal selection. There are still a lot of things to do. In France and in some countries in Europe, if you want to grow a grape, the variety has to be first registered in the French catalog. Today, or last year in 2020, there were exactly 428 varieties in the French catalog. Table grapes, wine grapes, varieties for juice, and varieties of rootstocks. If we split and if we consider only the wine grape varieties, there are 310 exclusive wine grape varieties. Roughly 200 are domestic native from France cultivar like Pinot Noir. Some come from foreign countries like Grenache, Garnacha, or Carignan, Carignan, Mataro. These varieties are from Spain. And there are some hybrid, interspecific hybrid like the Baco or Villard Blanc, Villard Noir, Chambourcin, and intraspecific hybrids like Marcelin or Caladoc, obtained by INRA at the end of the 50s. To grow a grape, so it's a bit of regulation, sorry, but I need to explain. To grow a grape, you need to get the registration into the French catalog. And what does it mean? You need to fill three conditions: getting a name of the new cultivar, and that name has to be undebatable. You need to proceed with the DUS, that means distinctiveness, uniformity, stability. It is nothing else than the global ampelographic description of the cultivar. And the third process is the value for cultivation or use, which is VCU. If you got these three conditions filled, then you can have the variety registered. Then you are authorized to propagate and sell the plants. But if you want to grow a wine grape varieties, if you want to make the wines, and if you want to sell the wines, you need to get what we call in France the classement, or the classification. It is specific to the wine grape market. Now I'm going to focus on the main challenges for the wine industry. For the wine industry in France, but I believe for the wine industry in Europe, and also in the world where we grow grapes. First, I do not invent anything. It's a climate change. I put a picture on the left, a picture I took in Montpellier roughly 2 years ago, when we beat the record of heat with 46 Celsius, roughly 115 Fahrenheit. It was the end of June 2019. And on the right, it is the compulsory reducing of the use of pesticides. By pesticides, I mean herbicides, fungicides, insecticides. There is a political orientation and there is a real tendency. And years after years, some chemicals are going to be to get removed from the authorization of spraying. So what can we expect, considering these challenges? What can we expect from clonal selection? I would say about the adaptation to the climate change in terms of phenology, accumulation of sugar, titrable acidity, there are quite good perspectives, and I'm going to develop these perspectives. In terms of adaptation to drought, to hydric stresses, yes, there are also perspectives, and considering that kind of adaptation, we have to consider that rootstocks can bring a good, can be a good tool, a good way to adapt. What about the resistance to fungal disease? I'm not sure it is clear enough, but you can see on the right side a tendril of a grenache. I took that picture in June 2018 in the south, where we had an important pressure with the downy mildew. Some old gentlemen, some old growers told me the 2018 was the worst year in terms of downy mildew since 1948. You can imagine. So what about the perspective the clonal selection can offer to adapt to the fungal disease? Telling you the truth, it is very limited, and there are a few range of Vitis vinifera that have a good tolerance to fungal disease. But we consider there are good things, good opportunities to adapt through what we call neglected or indigenous cultivar. Since the last 15 years, since 2006, we obtained the registration of 36 old cultivars. I put some names. Maybe you might be not familiar with these names. Some come from the east side, some from the Provence, some from the southwest. And there is a Carignan, gray Carignan, for instance. There is a Dureza, which is one of the parents of the Syrah with the Mondes Blanche. There is a Mondes Grise in Savoie. What else? And I put a picture of a cluster of the variety called Tardif. Tardif in French means late ripening. So this cultivar brings a good way to adapt. We also obtained the official registration of foreign cultivars since the last 15 years. Some from Spain, like Xarello, like Verdejo, some from Italy, like the Primitivo, mainly known under the name of Zinfandel in the US, or Calabrese from Italy, and some from Greece, like Xinomavro, or Agiorgitico for the red grapes, and Assyrtico for the whites. So 29 varieties that behave very well in their region of origin. And we believe that there is now an opportunity to try them, to experiment them in France. The reason why we obtain 30, the registration of 29 cultivars during the last 15 years. So If I put together the indigenous cultivar and the foreign cultivar, there are 65 new varieties that join the catalogue, which is a lot. What can they bring? I would say they will increase first the diversity. If you had a look on the slide, if you put together all the 20 main varieties in France, they represent 85% of the French vineyard. Having new varieties being authorized will increase, will restore the diversity, and there will be a good opportunity for redeveloping tourism or local market. Some are quite well adapted to the climate change because most of them, why they've been forgotten during 60, 50 years? Because they were of too high yield, of too late ripening, low accumulation of sugar and too high acidity. And today, considering the climate change, a late ripening, a low accumulation of sugar, a high acidity are qualities today. Some have been joined to the catalog because they got a good reputation. The wine world knows about Assyrtiko, the wine world knows about Albarino. And obviously, most of them, they make good wines. And something I will give a special focus is the evolution of the regulation with the appellation in France. Opening a door to this new material. So again, a picture I have taken in Montpellier 2 years ago. Everybody knows we in Western Europe, not only in France, but also in Spain, Italy, Germany, we had a big wave of frost 23 weeks ago. In some areas there where the temperature went down to -8, which is 18 Fahrenheit, with a lot of damage, maybe the worst frost since the 60s. What are the effects of the climate change? Because we consider, and I believe everybody believes the same, climate change is a fact, is a reality. What are the effects of the climate change? Mild winter means an early bud break and spring frost. A pitch of an old vineyard of Carignan near our facility 2 weeks ago. Rainfalls in total on the year. I cannot tell you there are less rainfalls, but we have erratic rainfalls. Means long period of drought. Hot summers, remember June 19, but we had also 2020 in Burgundy in Champagne was maybe an earlier vintage than 2003. 2003, everybody remembers 2003, which was a very, very hot vintage with a very high temperature during August in France. And earlier ripening mean high sugar and low acidity. And more frequent hailstorms everywhere in France, starting in spring. We had frost 2 weeks ago. 1 week ago, we had a storm of hail 10 kilometers from our facility. Everybody has that kind of information, the evolution of the maturity. I took that example with the cultivar Riesling in Alsace. In 30 years or 40 years, plus 2% of alcohol, which is a lot. What about now the new regulation that has been introduced by INAO? INAO is a national committee for the appellation of origin. I put the name in French What do I mean by variété d'intérêt à des fins d'adaptation? Means varieties of interest that could bring support, a complement within the regulation of the appellation. So what does it mean? It means it's each appellation has to define a short list of 10 variety, 10 reds and 10 whites. They have to, when the list has been officially adopted, they have to run an experimentation between 10 to 15 years. For the appellation, it is only variety that belong to the species Vitis vinifera. And the conditions are, it's 5% in the vineyard maximum and 10% in the bottle. You cannot put the mention, even on the back label, you cannot put the mention of the name of the variety. Then after the experimentation, after the 10 or 15 years, the decision will have to be made. We go or no go. And that belongs to the results, that belong to the appellation that will definitely adopt a new cultivar or not. For example, you've been aware that in Bordeaux, they define Bordeaux and Bordeaux Superior, they define a short list of two whites, Albarino and Liliorilla, and four reds, Arinarnoa, Castet, Marcelin, and Touriga Nacional. More recently in Côte de Provence, mainly for the production of light reds or rosé, they decide to introduce a variety from the south of Italy, Calabrese, plus two Greek cultivars, Xylomavro and Georgitico for the reds, the rosé or white Mosco Filero, and the Verdero from Spain. For example, with the Marcelin and the Arinarnois, which are INRA varietals, look, they've been obtained 60 years ago. So adopting an innovation takes a long time. And Liliorilla, I put a star on next to the name. Liliorilla is also a cultivar obtained by INRA. It's a cross between Chardonnay and Baroque. Baroque is an old cultivar from the Southwest. You see Marc Castet. Castet is an old cultivar from the Garonne River and Portuguese cultivar, the Touriga Nacional. So neglected cultivar, like Castet. Castet is a cultivar that bud break for the Castet will be 2 weeks later the Merlot. If you consider the risk of spring frost, it's a good thing. The wines of Castet are bodied, round, they are very, very good wines. Using a foreign cultivar because it ripes later, a good example is the Xylomavro. Xylomavro ripes 4 weeks later after the Merlot. And Xylomavro makes soft tannins like a Pinot style. Using variety that have a strong personality could be also a good support, like Assyrtiko. You know, Assyrtiko is the emblematic cultivar from the Santorini island, or Mosco Filero. So there are possibilities due to this new regulation in France. What about now, that the second part of the main focus of my presentation, what about the disease-resistant material? I have to give you some comments about the context. As I said, political and societal orientation, there is a tendency and we will not go back because chemicals are progressively banned and removed from the authorization of sale and use. And the wine industry is ready to go. The wine industry is ready to go, is ready to go because of pressure driven by the consumers, because of health issues. We cannot deny there are some health issues with the use of pesticide. And because if you spray half time, you will save money. So in terms of economy, you have to consider it could be a good thing. So I'm not talking about GMO. I'm just talking about classic breeding, hybridization, a dad, a mom, and we put them together and we obtain seeds. So it's like a bottleneck. because we start doing crossing and we obtain roughly 2,000 seeds, the seeds, we let them grow and we make a selection assisted by marker molecular to check about the genetics of the new plant, because a seed is a new cultivar. And then we do a first selection, which is during the stage, what we call the stage one. So we, from 2,000 seeds, we drop down to 100 individuals, 100 genotypes. And we plant them into the vineyards, between 5 to 10 plants. And during 6 years, we're gonna run a phenotyping. After this phenotyping, we will drop down to 10 to 15 pre-selected plants, and we will proceed, as I said, for the registration with the VCU, value for cultivation or use. And at the end, we hope we can get 2 to 3 varieties. So a brief summary on what has been done by INRA since the year 2000. INRA Colmar in Alsace has started a program called RESDUR, like resistance durable, sustainable resistance, RESDUR 1, 2, and 3. And you have on this slide the different generation of breedings, starting from the use of American VTs, the use of the species from the southeast of the US, Vitis rotundifolia or Muscadinia rotundifolia, and some species coming from Asia. And they obtain, during this long process, they obtain new cultivars. I want to tell you about the strategy in France. As you can see, I put the genes of resistance for each generation. So RPV stands for the resistance to downy mildew. REN, R-U-N or R-E-N, REN, stands for the resistance to the powdery mildew. We call that the pyramiding. At least, that's a national strategy, at least 2 genes of resistance per cultivar to make sure we have a more sustainable resistance. So what has been obtained through the program INRA RESDUR 1, 4 cultivars, Artaban, Vidoc for the reds, Floreal and Voltis for the whites. They are now being propagated, and after 3 years, 3 years after their registration, there are approximately 1,000 hectares in France, which is a good success. Means there is an important interest for this cultivar. And some, I'm not talking about the appellation, but some have been already introduced into the vin de pays because it is allowed. For the RESDUR 2 generation, some will be registered next year, and the RESDUR 3 is still in the pipeline. VCU is in progress. There is an observatory, a national observatory called OSCAR, which is developed by INRA to make sure we can get information from the wine industry about how do these varieties behave. We can do mechanization, how do they behave in the different terroirs. So it's a platform of collaboration that can be fed by everyone that makes its own experimentation on this cultivar. So something very new we started in 2013 is what we call absorption crossing, or anticipating tomorrow's grape cultivar. What do we mean by that? We are now doing breedings using resistant genotypes that carry the resistance to the fungal disease. And we do crossing times emblematic cultivars in order to get, at the end of the process, new cultivars that will have the quality given by the parents and the resistance given by the other parent, the resistant genotype. Here is a view on all the programs that have been started. You have the logo of the interprofessional committees, and you can read by yourself, and you will meet all most of our main emblematic cultivars, Riesling, Gewürztraminer, Pinot, Chardonnay, Syrah, Grenache, what else? Colombard, Cabernet Franc, Uniblanc, Chenin, Sauvignon. Every big interprofessional committee, has started with IAV, INRA, that kind of program. Some small appellations have also joined that kind of program, like Muscat Petit Grain for the appellation Clairette de Die, which is a small sparkling appellation, and appellation Picpoul de Pinet using the emblematic and old cultivar Picpoul Blanc. I'm go back to this slide. That's a very, very important challenge, because we said to the wine industry, we cannot tell you, we are sure we're going to succeed. But it's a kind of guess. It's a kind of bet to the future. We start, and we will see in 2030, so in less than 10 years, in 2035, if we have new cultivars that can be developed for the French wine industry. So additional information you will find after my presentation on the website vignevin.com. You can see some information in English. There is also the ANTAV INRA.fr website, where you can find information. The website Plant Grape, where you can meet all the French cultivars that are registered in the French catalogue, plus the clone, the 1030 clones. This Plant Grape website has been now translated and updated in English and in Spanish. And what is going to be released soon is an application for the ANTAV INRA clone. We consider it will be what we call an indispensable tool that will help the nurseries, the growers, to find what could be the most appropriate clones when they have a program of plantation. I would like to finish my presentation mentioning the companies we've been working with in California, some nurseries, Sunridge Nurseries, Eric Grapevine, wonderful nurseries, Guillaume Grapevine in California, and in Washington State, Inland Desert Nursery. We have a long-term partnership with them. They grow all the clones that have been introduced in California. Over than 150 clones now available. I put some clones of Cabernet Sauvignon on the slide. And it's a pipeline of introduction of my plant material. There are cultivars and clones for diversification coming soon. The Mediterranean cultivars, like the one from Greece, coming soon. And in the future, we will introduce some powdery mildew, downy mildew, resistant cultivars. Just to sum up and conclude, I want to tell you that through the plant material, we have one of the most promising means to adapt viticulture. Not the only one, but a good way to adapt. If we would consider climate change and pesticides issues separately, we would make a big mistake. We have to consider all these challenges together. Through the existing diversity, there is a lot to explore and to expect. Hybridization, since we can get technical support through genomic selection, we can speed up the process and we can be more efficient. Emerging disease, it's an issue, it's a concern. It's a concern because we need now to run collaboration at an international level, doing pre-breeding versus some disease like Pierce disease. Pierce disease is in Spain, and we are it's a threat for the industry in France, in Italy, in the rest of Europe. what can we expect from the evolution of the regulation? The first step, as I mentioned, the variety of adaptation has been launched 2 years ago. And the next step will be, when will the AOC, the appellation, when they will include the non-vinifera plant material, because today in Tuscany, in the Rioja, in the Douro, in Portugal, in all the appellation in Europe, you can go only a pure vitis vinifera. Thank you very much for your attention. I would like to thank my colleague, Loïc Lecoeuf and Olivier Yobrega from IAV, and also Christophe Scheder from INRA, and I'm ready to answer your questions. Thank you.